Good morning, boys and girls. It's me again. Today for maths, we are going to be looking at telling the time. Okay. This video is going to be a little bit longer than normal, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Okay. We're going to focus on three main parts. Firstly, how to tell the time on an analog clock, how to convert analog time to digital time, and lastly, how to change between a 12-hour and a 24-hour clock. All of this we have done before. It's just to help jog your memories and recap. Okay, so let's start with this clock. Okay, this is a normal clock that you see just about anywhere. It has 12 hours on it. Okay. Now, on this clock, you get two hands, a long hand and a short hand. The long hand is the minute hand. And the short hand is the hour hand. Okay, just like I always tell you, minute is the long hand because the word minute is longer. Hour is the short hand because the word hour is shorter. Okay, so on this clock, we can see the hours. But with the two different hands, you can also see the minutes. Because each of these is a 5-minute interval, a 5-minute gap. So in essence, we count 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Okay, so if the minute hand is pointing there, it is 5 minutes past whatever the hour might be. 10 past, quarter past, 20 past, 25 past, and half past. So this side is the past side. Now, as soon as your minute hand gets past half past, we don't say it's 55 minutes past or it's 40 minutes past. We now start saying 2. So if you look at the arrows I've drawn on the outside, this one goes this way because we count 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. This arrow, you'll notice, goes the other way around. That's because we count 5 minutes to the hour, 10 minutes to the next hour, quarter to the next hour, 20 to the next hour, and 25 to that hour. So let's write 2 on this side. Okay. So if I draw a time, let me give us. What would that time be? Okay, this is the minute hand, the hour hand. So we can see we are on that side of the clock, so it's 2. So we have to count this way around. So let's go. It is 5, it is 10 minutes to 2. It's not 2 o'clock yet. In 10 minutes from right now, it will be 2 o'clock. And when it's 2 o'clock, this one would have made its way to the 12, to the hour. Okay, so that is how, very briefly, to tell analog time. Let's have a look at converting between analog and digital. Now, on a digital clock, you have something that looks like that. You have a number, dot, dot, another number. Now, what this means, this is the hour side and the minute side. So if we had to look at this time, now I've done it on purpose, giving us a 2. When we do digital time, it changes slightly. So we still go 5 past, 10 past, quarter past, 20 past, 25 past, half past. Now this clock is slightly different. We go 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, and o'clock. Okay, at o'clock there are no minutes. So this time, if I look at it, starting with the minutes, we would be on, the minute hand is pointing to the 10, which in digital, these are your digital clues. Okay, in digital time, we need to write 50. Okay. Which, if we went back to this clock, would mean that it is 5, 10, 2 the next hour. It's not that time yet. So if I look here, it is 10 to which hour? It's 10 to 2. So do I write 2 there? No. I have to write 1. Okay, it's not 2 o'clock yet. In 10 minutes time, because 50 plus 10 gives us 60, would take us to our hour. So in 10 minutes time, it will be 2 o'clock. It is 10 to 2. If I had written 2:50, that would simply mean that it is in 10 minutes time, it will be 3 o'clock. And there's a very big difference between 10 to 2 and 10 to 3. Okay. So that is digital time very briefly. All you need to know is if you're struggling, draw a clock face and fill in 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55 hour. Okay. The only tricky part about converting between digital and analog is knowing when to put which hour. Okay, if it's 2 the next hour, it means we are not there yet. The last one, 12 hour to 24 hour, most of us in class managed to get this one quite easily, so it's not too much of a stress at the moment, but let's just have a look. If the time was, if the time was 6:15, and I wrote that digitally, okay, that's hours, minutes, the minutes would be 5:10:15, and it's 6:15 which hour? 6:15. So now I can safely write 6. Okay. This, let's say, is in 12 hours. In a day, there are 2 6 o'clocks. There's 6 o'clock in the morning when you wake up, and there is 6 o'clock in the evening, just before you go to bed. If I wanted to show that that was 6 o'clock in the morning, and I'm doing it in 12 hours, I would just write AM next to it. If it was in the afternoon, I would write PM next to it. If it was a 12 hour clock only goes up to 12. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. But on a 24 hour, okay, there are 24 hours. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Then the 1 o'clock in the afternoon is 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, and then 00. Okay, so there are 24 hours. So if I wanted to change my 6:15 to being in the evening, the later one, the minutes would stay the same. So it's still 15, it's still 6:15. But my 6 o'clock would now be 1800. Yeah. So it's 6:15. When I use 24 hours, I don't need to write AM or PM, simply because the number itself tells me whether it's in the morning or in the evening. Okay. So that was a very, very brief and quick recap of time. I hope it helped. I hope it helped to jog some memories. If you're still stuck, turn back in your textbook and have a look through the chapter. And if that doesn't help, then please feel free to contact me. Okay. Good luck, enjoy the activity, and I hope you're having a good time at home. Bye.